They inspire national pride and a sense of patriotism, more so when they are on parade during national celebrations. Join Betty Kialo. She takes us through the drills of a military parade on how things work.
The color, the numbers on the ground, the fighter jets in the skies. Uniformed servicemen and women at their best. But for this kind of celebrations to be marked in splendor, a lot of effort that you don't get to see goes into it. Ever wondered what goes behind the scenes to prepare for the national holiday celebrations? Tonight, we'll show you on how things work. It is 5 days before this year's Mashujaa Day celebrations at the Nyayo National Stadium. We arrive early morning and find the country's security forces comprising of the Navy, Army and Air Force already rehearsing for the big day. They have been here for the last 3 weeks, going through the same routine every single day to ensure clinical accuracy and, of course, that there are no mishaps as Kenya watches come the 20th.
There are some instructors who are looking at the saluting. Some are looking at the turns we are making and the moves we are making. So they are particular about those specific activities. Once they see a mistake, it's corrected. So it's repeated over and over. It's out of the repetitions that we do that the soldiers now get so much conversant with the guard of honor and the activities that involve the whole issue of parade.
It is an elaborate rehearsal with each force led by its own commander who oversees the drills.
They are doing a lot of rehearsals on movements, on saluting, on how they're going to present their arms, for example, if it's in a guard of honor.
The senior officers we talk to tell us the disciplined forces are on the field by 6 a.m. and not a second later. It is at this time that each commander conducts individual rehearsals with the force, and after at least 4 hours of practice at 10 a.m., all the troops come together to conduct an all-inclusive practice that takes another 2 hours. They march into the stadium and take position.
We have teams from the Army, from the Air Force, and from the Navy. So once we combine all these groups, it's a tri-service guard of honor.
The senior commanders tell me that the rehearsals are taken so seriously that the difference between the rehearsals and the actual D-Day performance is hardly noticeable. Well, except that on the actual day, they put on the ceremonial uniform. For a parade to be considered perfect, the music must also be perfect. It takes months of practice for the military band to be in sync when performing a song. I am told the music to be played is selected on the basis of the current hits or simply uplifting songs that would cut across generations. Modern or traditional patriotic songs are also popular selections. Nothing is left to chance with the music. They are expected to read and play the music, all the while marching in crisp order.
We have the tune special for bringing in the whole team. That's the guard of honor. And then we have two other tunes. That's for the inspection. And the one tune which brings the guest of honor all the way to the dais. And then we have the seven other tunes for the marching contingents.
While this is going on, other preparations are taking place. Inside the stadium, the lawns are trimmed as the flags are hoisted around the stadium. After the rehearsals, the last lap of honor is done as the troops, including other forces, leave the stadium.
Thank you.
day, everything comes to play. However, something that you may not know is that in the event an officer becomes sick during the parade, other officers referred to as spares take over their place for a smooth transition that you may not even notice while watching the parade.
We get some spares who are actually behind the parade. So if a soldier falls down, which is so rare anyway, this assistance or the spare soldiers comes in, takes his place.
And that is what goes on behind the scenes to prepare for national holiday celebrations. Betty Kialo, How Things Work.